Think that if you're in a boy band, you don't write music, you don't produce music, that you were put together by some mastermind and you're just a bunch of puppets really marketed towards young teen girls. And that's not the case with us. I mean, we put ourselves together for music. We write music, we produce music, we know a little bit about music. Actually, we know a lot about music.
Yeah, I mean, more than a little bit, but I don't know if we know a lot.
Well, it just depends. We know a lot. These guys were actually, the other guys in the group were actually in a performing arts school raised on music. So, we do know music. We know several different genres of music. We are influenced by many, many types of music. So, we don't consider ourselves that kind of a thing. We don't consider ourselves a teen phenomenon. We have a great teen audience and they've done many, many things for us, but we also have a very big adult audience, which a lot of people don't know because they...
There's a lot of negative stereotypes that go along with being a boy band. And I think that if people redefine the term and there weren't the stereotypes of lip syncing and having no creative control and just being about dancing and not really having any talent, if those weren't that wasn't the stigma about being a boy band, I don't think anybody would mind being referred to as that. But I just think... being considered a boy band really limits you as far as what you can do musically and professionally. I mean, it really puts a blockade on how long you can stay in this business. The songs we're writing recently have become more expressions of ourselves, things that have made us mad, things that we're going through, different things. So I think, like I said earlier, the more you write, the better you get, and the more it really expresses yourself. They don't become cliches, they become stories about your life. So I think definitely you can express yourself better through song than you can through verbalization. Seduce me, cause I do cherish you for the rest of my life. You don't have to think twice, I will.
How many times were you in high school and you saw a guy that you liked, or for us, a girl that we liked? I would never approach a girl in high school. I was very, very shy. So you would write it down. You write a note. You know what I mean? Say something in the note. Say things that you were feeling in a note that you could never, say face to face with somebody. That's the same thing as what we're doing when we're on stage and we're singing to a mass group of people and girls. And we just think about the person that we really want to say it to, and kind of like. The people in the audience personify that person or represent that person.
You got to continue to set goals. That's what we did our whole career. We had the goal of, all right, we want to get signed. All right, we want to get our record out. We want to go top 10. We want to have a platinum album. We just kept setting new goals and raising the bar. And now, I mean, we got a triple platinum album in the States, platinum albums, platinum Christmas albums. So we just got to keep raising the bar, and the next album is very exciting for us.
Me, I never imagined in a million years that I would be involved with something like this. I mean, to me, it's a dream come true and something that I cherish, and it's something that we all cherish. I mean, I think the other guys were more confident in their abilities because of they're very, very talented guys. They've been raised around music and been performing for a long time. But me, I never dreamt it. I used to watch it on TV and never would have thought back then that I would be in the position that I am now, and I think that just makes me want to work even harder and makes me cherish it even more and appreciate it even more.
I really feel like this next album is our way of separating ourselves from the pop phenomenon, the way of showing our maturity, the way of growing as artists, as growing as songwriters, producers. Of lip syncing and having no creative control and just being about dancing and not really having any talent. If those weren't that wasn't the stigma about being a boy band, I don't think anybody would mind being referred to as that. But I just think being considered a boy band really limits you as far as what you can do musically and professionally. I mean, it really puts a blockade on how long you can stay in this business.
Right. I mean, I agree. I mean, people think that if you're in a boy band, you don't write music, you don't produce music, that you were put together by some mastermind and you're just a bunch of puppets really marketed towards young teen girls. And that's not the case with us. I mean, we put ourselves together for music.
When you're singing, it's more of a performance. When you're on stage, it's kind of like an escape. You can get up there and do whatever, and it's not necessarily you, it's just what you want to do. I mean, it's not necessarily what Drew or Jeff would do walking down the street, but... You're given a lot more freedom, and I think that that's a big reason about art in general, whether it's painting, music, dance. It allows you to express yourself in ways that you couldn't just verbally. So I think for us, it's definitely a kind of a release, kind of a way of expressing ourselves. And I mean, a lot of the songs we're writing recently have become more expressions of ourselves, things that have made us mad, things that we're going through, just, I mean, different things. So I think, like I said earlier, the more you write, the better you get, and the more it really expresses yourself. They don't become cliches, they become stories about your life. So I think definitely you can express yourself better through song than you can through verbalization.
A lot of times your music reflects your personality, and we're very romantic guys. I mean, we're not softies or anything like that, but we're in between a softie and a, I don't think we're too soft, but, you know, we're definitely romantic guys. We're guys that fall, I mean, at least me anyway, I can speak for myself, I fall easily for a pretty face and a nice girl with a good sense of humor. It doesn't take much for me. But we usually sing music that's from the heart and also that other people can relate to. And love is definitely something that everyone can relate to, and it's a universal appeal. And that's why we sing the songs we do. We like to pick songs with kind of cool lyrics, you know, lyrics with a different twist. Invisible Man, The Hardest Thing are good examples of that. You know, so, you know, we just like to sing things that we care about, sing about things that we care about, and love is obviously a very major, major part of our lives.
You can never sit back, relax, and enjoy it, or else that's when you fall. You can never get complacent, you can never become, you can be satisfied with the goals you've achieved, but you can't be content. You have to just keep setting new goals for yourself and raising the bar, raising the standard. Even if you sold more records than anybody else in the world, you gotta try to set a new goal, reach another standard, raise the bar, or else you're just gonna get lazy and just fall off. You gotta continue to set goals. And that's what we did our whole career. We had the goal of, all right, we wanna get signed. All right, we wanna get our record out. We wanna go top 10. We want to have a platinum album. We just kept setting new goals and raising the bar. And now, I mean, we got a triple platinum album in the States, platinum albums, platinum Christmas albums. So we just got to keep raising the bar. And the next album is very exciting for us.
And those goals are all cool. And you know, and for us, those aren't the primary goals to be met. The primary goals for us are, of course, the musical goals. And you know, our big thing now is to write more, get more creative as artists, use other elements of music, not just pop, but R&B and rock and other types of music, jazz, even more, and make us more well-rounded musicians, make more of a creation that people can distinguish us from other people. And that's one of our main goals that we're working on now.